Lesson 47, Preparing the Way of the Lord. In today's lesson, we learn about the ministry of John the Baptist and how he was called to prepare the way of the Lord. John was a poor man living in the wilderness, but a man prepared by God to do a great work for God. We shall see that God's greatest servants need not be rich or well-dressed, but men of conviction and willing to preach righteousness. John was baptizing people in the Jordan River, and many came to him to be baptized. The people recognized in John that he was a man sent from God to prophesy and preach the truth. Many asked him about what they should do, for they were under conviction because of their sin. John was very clear in telling everyone how to walk in righteousness before God. He taught people to be honest and to love their neighbor as themselves and to repent from all their evil ways. John was very bold in preaching, calling the religious hypocrites a brood of snakes and challenging them about who warned them to flee from God's wrath. His preaching certainly was not designed to tickle the ears of his listeners, but to bring about conviction concerning sin. He was not at all popular with those religious elite who thought themselves to be more righteous than others. As John preached so boldly against sin and against religious hypocrisy, the people saw greatness in him and marveled at his zeal to honor God. They wondered if John might be the Messiah, and so they asked him if he was the expected Messiah of Israel. When John was asked about this, he quickly responded that he was not, but there was one coming after him who was greater than he, and whose shoes he was not worthy to untie. John had a very high view of God's Messiah and a very humble view of himself. This is what made John such a great prophet for God. Though John was a mighty servant for God and honored by some, he was also hated by others. Herod was the king over the Jews, though still under the Roman authorities. Herod had some respect for John, for he knew he was favored among the people of Israel. But he also had something against him that was personal. Herod had taken for himself the wife of his brother Philip, which was not lawful. John had spoken publicly against Herod's sin, and Herod was not happy about this. His wife also hated John and wanted him dead. Herod, however, feared the people, for he knew they counted John as a prophet. So he contented himself with putting John in prison. And later we learn that Herod is forced against his better judgment to execute John. John the Baptist did much to turn the heart of the people of Israel back to their God and back to the ways of righteousness. This prepared the way for the coming of the Messiah. The greatest work of John was to announce to the nation of Israel the arrival of their Messiah. Actually, it was God in heaven who approved Jesus as his beloved Son, his anointed. John had the privilege to baptize Jesus, and after he was baptized, the Spirit of God descended on him like a dove, and a voice from heaven announced, "You are my beloved Son, in you I am well pleased." This marked the beginning of Jesus' public ministry to the nation of Israel and identified him as God's chosen Messiah and Redeemer. Luke tells us that Jesus was about 30 years old when he began his public ministry. Luke provides a genealogy of Jesus the Christ, beginning with Jesus himself and working backwards all the way to Adam, the first man. There are 75 generations from Adam to Jesus listed by Luke, and this is to verify his legal and human ancestry, and as being a Jew under the law. Luke differs from Matthew's genealogy in that Matthew focuses on Jesus' right to the throne of David and as the heir of the promises made to Abraham. Luke is more concerned with the true humanity of Jesus and thus follows his lineage all the way back to Adam, and using the lineage of Mary, not Joseph. Though Joseph's name is mentioned, he was the legal father and not the physical father of Jesus. Jesus was physically born to Mary, and her father was Heli, And so the genealogy traces his human lineage all the way back to Adam. Luke is affirming to us the true humanity of our Lord Jesus Christ, and that as Adam's descendant, he would crush Satan under his feet, as the prophecy in Genesis was made concerning the seed of the woman, Genesis chapter 3, verse 15. Luke has shown us how John the Baptist was used by God to prepare the way for the coming of the Messiah, who was the son of Adam, and he who would deliver Israel and destroy Satan. The rest of his gospel will show us that Jesus was indeed the son of Adam, that is, a true man, and also God's means of redeeming his people and overthrowing the power of Satan. God did not need to use a man like John to prepare for the coming of the Messiah, for Jesus himself could have done everything that John had done, and much more. However, God was pleased to use this man to preach righteousness and turn the hearts of people back to God. It cost him his life to speak against sin, but God was honored and John rewarded in heaven. I hope that you also will be willing to take your stand against sin, no matter what it may cost. Then he said to the multitudes that came out to be baptized by him, "Brood of vipers, who warned you to flee from the wrath to come?" Luke chapter 3, verse 7.